These are our brothers and sisters, our friends, our family. We are done watching them die. We are no longer bystanders. We will not be idle. Enough is enough.
I will no longer allow an unchecked moment. I will no longer allow racist, hurtful words, jokes, stereotypes, no matter how big or small, to be uttered in my presence.
The communist Chinese used to call these struggle sessions, where you came forward and you confessed your sins. It's kind of creepy, and you're seeing this kind of stuff all over the place, not just in Hollywood, but in corporate America. And the Chinese, I believe, started this, or at least took it to a whole new level. Let's bring in the historian, shall we? Craig Shirley, Reagan biographer, presidential historian. Welcome back, Craig. And Doug Weed, presidential historian, author, Inside Trump's White House, and a former advisor to George H.W. Bush. Welcome, gentlemen. Craig, what's happening here does seem like a page right out of the Chinese playbook.
Sure does. Sure does. What's interesting, too, is the cultural similarities. Mao used young people in the 60s as his militant arm to purge Chinese society of the last remaining vestiges of capitalism and freedom and things like that. And they were fanatics. And now you see it today. The young people who are fanatics in our society today being used to torture and terrorize Americans. And so there's many similarities between the Cultural Revolution of Communist China and what's going on with the woke movement of America today. Very similar.
I want to show you, Doug and Craig, a Norman Rockwell original, one that I really liked as a kid, Freedom of Speech. And a man stands up and makes his case at a town meeting. And it's very beautiful, very powerful, very... There it is, and it's a classic. A lot of folks know this one, but there's a problem for folks on the left. It's all white people, and they don't like that. So it's been reimagined, and let's take a look at the new version, the new improved version. Yes, all the white men have been erased, and I understand, in part, they want to make it more inclusive and make it a statement, but I quite frankly, am kind of creeped out by it. It's one thing to bring more people on board, but they seem to be pushing people out at the same time, Doug.
Yeah, it's interesting, and it can get worse, Greg. By the way, congratulations on the award you won, and Chris Ruddy, and being the fourth highest rated news. Wow, a little Craig Shirley and Doug Weed get to be on your show. But yeah, it got real bad, the Cultural Revolution. Young people would go into the street in Beijing and they would pull drivers out of automobiles and whip them because they were stopping on red and going on green. And they wanted that changed. You would go on red and stop on green. They went into apartments where they would kill the birds in cages, pet birds, because they were eating grain and people were starving in China. So it can get worse. The communists concluded the economic revolution didn't work because they'd failed to complete the cultural revolution. And that's what they're focusing on now in America.
We know that Joe Biden's son, Hunter, has had lots of dealings with China, and I have heard Joe Biden brag that he and President Xi have spent so much time together. I think we have a picture of the two of them. He's bragged about that quite openly, that they're tight and they spend a lot. I wonder what's going on. What's really going on here? Gentlemen, I'm sorry we're a little bit short on time tonight. Satellite window closing, but we will continue this conversation. Craig Shirley, Doug Weed, we thank you so much. To be continued for sure. But standing by right now is Grant Stinchfield with a special preview of a show. Hi, Grant.
Hey, Greg. So, look, I love the 1-2 punch that you and I got going, right?